outside. Have you
more we can bring without actually impacting the economy of the Puerto Rico? If I keep on flooding the place with food and water, when is it that the local neighbors are going to open their supermarkets?
Isn't it true that FEMA had a presence in New Orleans for like 7 years, right? People were living in FEMA trailers for years.
We were in New Orleans just 2 years ago, and we left 5,000 mobile homes there.
Right.
And we were there for 7-8 months responding there. And we're in Florida, and we're in Harvey, and we're going to be in Puerto Rico, and now we're in Virgin Islands also, for as long as it takes.
For
as long as it takes.
Despite what the president says.
You know what? We don't follow, I don't see TV, so I don't even pay attention to that. I pay attention to the mission that I have in my heart, which is fixing Puerto Rico.
In just the few hours we've been out shooting, an amazing development here at this abandoned airport. The Air National Guard out of Tennessee and Kentucky has arrived and are militarizing this airport. They tell me off camera they got 500 guys, more are coming, that they've been sitting back home for 2 weeks, chomping at the bit to come, but there's so many layers of bureaucratic red tape, they just couldn't pull the trigger. But the good news is, they are here now. They've got supplies, and they're gonna start pushing them into the mountains as soon as they possibly can.
And Bill joins me now from San Juan. I mean, at today's White House briefing, Sir Sanders said, we're continuing to do everything that we can to help the people of Puerto Rico. You've been there over the last few weeks. I mean, does the outlook on the ground match up with what we're hearing from the White House?
Well, maybe now that these guys are actually arriving and they've been wanting to arrive for 2 weeks, that's what the guardsmen told you. Just by point of comparison, Snappers, the bar on Key Largo that got obliterated 38 days ago by Irma, is open for business tonight. You go around Puerto Rico a month after Maria, and it's hard to see that anything has changed. There's so much to do here, but a good sign that the Guard is here now.
Yeah, and so frustrating that, you know, a lot of those guys you talked to off camera are saying they've been sitting around for 2 weeks chomping at the bit. I mean, I talked to first responders when I was there, heard the same thing. They'd been there for days wanting to get out, and we're just waiting around. We're frustrated. Bill, I'm glad you're there. Thanks for the reporting, as always. It's hand things over to Dana Bash and Jake Tapper, the CNN debate with Senator Bernie Sanders, as well as Senator Ted Cruz on the GOP tax plan. That starts right now.
Live from Washington, this is CNN's debate night with Senators Bernie Sanders and Ted Cruz. At issue, President Trump's new tax plan. Will Congress go for it, and how might it affect your wallet? I'm Jake Tapper.
And I'm Dana Bash. This morning, President Trump again promised his plan will be a boon to small businesses and the middle class. But President Trump's critics say the plan is a huge boost to the rich and might even raise taxes for some in the middle class.
Meanwhile, President Trump's Treasury Secretary is saying that the stock market, now at a record high, will drop if Congress does not cut taxes. Senator Cruz supports the president's effort to lower taxes. Senator Sanders opposes it.
Gentlemen, welcome. A reminder, you will get 90 seconds to answer questions from us and our audience, 45 seconds for responses and rebuttals. Senators, let's start with your opening arguments. You each have 1 minute. Senator Cruz, we'll start with you.
Dana, thank you. I want to thank CNN and Jake and Dana both for hosting this, everyone for coming out. And Bernie, thank you for joining us. Now, tonight, I'm going to make a prediction. Bernie's going to suggest in just a few seconds that this is not really about you. This is about, quote, taxing the rich. That's what the Democrats always say. But here's what you need to know. Every time Bernie says the rich, what he means is taxpayers. And so if you pay taxes, he's talking about you. Now, how do we know this? We know this because there's a difference between facts and rhetoric. Bernie's tax plan cost over $13 trillion. That's what he's proposed raising in new taxes. And who pays for it? Well, the Democrats always talk about the millionaires and billionaires. But here's a simple fact. We could take every single person making